गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? ओके, वेल, वेरी गुड। सो यस्टरडे वी हैव डन 10th क्लास, 6 चैप्टर्स, बेसिक ऑफ दैट चैप्टर्स, सम थिंग अबाउट सिमिलरिटी ऑफ ए ट्रायंगल्स एंड योर होमवर्क इज दिस, सॉल्व दिस एक्सरसाइज 6.1। I also want to tell answer of these questions which are given in exercise of 6.1. First question is given, all circle are congruent or similar? All circle are similar. Why similar? Because all are in the same ratio. Congruent need not be. To become a congruent, two circle need same radius. All square are again what? Similar. All fill in the blanks triangle are similar. Equilateral triangles. All equilateral triangles are similar. So in this way you can solve. Remaining if any problem, discuss with me. Send your WhatsApp. I can tell you this is your problem. Like this question number 2, 4th part and this 3rd question, if any problem, then we will discuss. Now next part of this chapter, similarity of triangles. In NCERT books, page number 123 given, what you can say about the similarity of two triangles? You may recall that triangle is also a polygon. Polygon, what's the polygon? Having more than two sides, so triangle is also a polygon. So we can state the same condition for the similarity of two triangles, that is, two triangles are said to be similar if corresponding angles are equal. So I am telling about these corresponding angle also. Like this, this is a triangle ABC and this is a triangle DEF, and this is the symbol of similar. If these two triangles are similar, it's meaning triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. What's its meaning? Its meaning, angle A is equal to angle D and both are corresponding angle. Angle B equal to angle E and angle C equal to angle F. This is saying corresponding angle of a triangle. And their corresponding sides, if you are talking about this triangle, which triangle? ABC. ABC is similar to triangle, which triangle? DEF. Which corresponding? AB corresponding which sides? AB corresponding which side? DE. BC correspondence where? EF. And AC correspondence what? DF. This is saying corresponding. So saying like this, two triangles are similar if its corresponding angle are equal, and second condition is what? Their corresponding side are in the same ratio. So this is meaning same ratio mean AB by DE is equal to BC by EF is equal to AC by what? DF, which is equal to same ratio. That's you can say key. Note that if the corresponding angle of two triangles are equal, then this is known as equiangular triangles. If the all the three angle of one triangle is equal to the all the three angle of another triangle, so this is what's the name of this type of triangle? Equiangular triangle. What's triangle? Equiangular triangle. Here angle A is equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle E, and angle C is equal to what? Angle C equal to angle F. This thing. So these two triangles are equiangular if angle A equal to D, angle B equal to E, angle C equal to angle F. There is one famous Greek mathematician Thales telling about the ratio of the two corresponding sides in two equilateral triangles is always same. Thales saying like this: if the two triangles are equiangular, you understand, all the triangle of one triangle is equal to the all the triangle of another triangle, then their corresponding sides are in the same ratio. He proved that. So after that, one condition reduced to prove that two triangles are similar. If we can prove all the three angle of one triangle is equal to all the three angle of another triangle, then the two triangles are similar. One activity given in your book also, its name is activity number 2. What's name? Activity number 2. What's given? Draw an angle XAY. This is a ray. Which ray? AX or XA you can say. Making angle. What angle? Acute angle. Another ray. This is Y. And marks the point, which point? Open your compass and marks point like this. First point name is P, second point name is Q, third point name is D, fourth name is R, and fifth name is P. And also satisfying this condition, AP equal to PQ is equal to QD is equal to DR is equal to RB is equal to BX. All are equal. All are equal. Now through B you can join Y. What you can join? B joined with Y, or B you can say B you can join here with any point here. What's the name of this point? You can say C. What's this point name is? C. Also 3D, this is D. Draw a line which is parallel to BC. Which is parallel to BC. Which is parallel to BC, and name of this point is E. So here two triangles. Which triangle? Triangle AED and triangle ACB. And both are similar. Both are similar. Or you can say AD. AD is this. So how many units? 3. AD by DB. AD by DB is equal to how much? 3 by 2. This is 1 unit. This is showing up to here 1 unit, 2 unit, 3 unit. And DB is what? 1 unit, 2 unit. That's why written 3 by 2. Then you can measure AE. If you can measure AE and EC, this is also equal to 3 by 2. If you can measure it, its meaning AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. If you don't know how can these two triangles are similar, I can tell. Triangle AED is similar to triangle ACB. Here angle A equal to angle A, common in both. This angle, it means angle AED equal to angle ACB. According to your construction, this is parallel to this. And similarly, angle ADE equal to angle ABC. show all three angles are equal. It means two triangles are. Its meaning all three angles of this triangle is equal to all three angles of this. Now we will, what we can do, we will check its correspondence side ratio. So this equal, its meaning this is equal to 3/2. Then you can measure one more ratio, ED by BC. This is also 3/2. So what you can say? You can say like this, these all are equal. So first theorem related to that, which is given, if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle, this is a triangle given. What's the name of triangle? ABC. What's name of the triangle? ABC. If a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle intersect the other two side in different point, the other two side divide in the same ratio. So your theorem is what? If a line drawn through the one, so it's like this, if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle is divide the other two side in the same ratio. So I'm saying like this, first you can write what? You can write given in triangle, what triangle? ABC. One point its name is D and this name is E. In triangle AB, DE is parallel to BC. D is parallel to BC. To prove, what you have to prove in it? You have to prove AD by DB. AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Proof of this, you have to tell. First, what you have to do? You have to join B with E and D with C and draw perpendicular from D to DM and draw DM perpendicular on what? AC and EN perpendicular on AP. This is like this. This point name is what? N. Understood or not? This is our construction. Join B and E, C and D. Now come on the proof. In triangle, which triangle? A D E. What's the area of triangle AD? ADE. What's the area of this triangle? ADE. 1/2 base into height. This is a formula for finding the area of a triangle. So 1/2 base is what? If we can take base as AN, then what's its perpendicular? H is the perpendicular height. That's EN. Understood? And another way also by which we can find out the area of this triangle is 1/2 base into height. 1/2 base we have taken. What we have taken? AE we have taken base. And what's its perpendicular? DM. Understood this? This you can say first, this is you can say second. Now, in triangle, which triangle? BDE. What's its area of triangle BDE is equal to 1/2 b base into height. What's its base? Base is, what's its base? DB. And what's its height? EN. What's its height? EN. Some student don't understanding why its height EN taken. EN is perpendicular on AB. EN is perpendicular on AB. So EN definitely perpendicular on its parts. Understood? Similarly, area of triangle, which triangle you can say DEC, DEC. What's the area of this triangle? 1 by 2 base into height. Again same procedure, 1 by 2, what's its base? EC. What's its base? EC. And what's its perpendicular height? DM. Again same region, DM is perpendicular on AC, so DM definitely perpendicular on EC. Region you can write here, first region is what? EN in perpendicular on AB, so what is this? DM is perpendicular on AC. Understood this or not understood? So now, therefore, area of triangle ADE by area of triangle what? BDE. Area of this triangle AD is what? This 1 by 2 EN into AN. EN into AD, sorry. AD into AD coming here. Wrong written this. AD. AD into EN. Divide by triangle BDE area is what? 1 by 2 DB into EN. 1 by 2 cancel, 1 by 2 EN cancel, 1 by, this is coming AD by DB. AD by DB. Now, area of triangle, which triangle? ADE by area of triangle, which triangle? DEC. DEC. Again, second one you can take. 1 by 2 into what? AE into DM divided by what? DEC area is what? 1 by 2 EC into DM. 1 by 2 cancel, 1 by DM cancel DM. It's meaning AE by EC. Understood? If by applying any method we can prove, here numerator of both fraction are triangle ABD, area of triangle ADE, area of triangle AD. If by applying any method we can prove area of these two triangles, triangle BDE and triangle DEC are same, then we can say these both are equal. But area of triangle, which triangle? DEC is equal to area of triangle BDE. Why? Because both triangle BDE, BDE and triangle DEC lying on the same base, which base? Both triangle lying on the same DE and between the parallel BC, because DE is parallel to BC. Both triangle lying on the same base and between the same parallels. So both are equal. Therefore, you can write area of triangle ADE is equal to divide by area of triangle BDE. is equal to area of triangle ADE is equal divided by area of triangle DEC. What is this? It's meaning AD, this given by DB is equal to AE by AC. Hence what? Truth. What truth? This is saying again, I want to repeat, line drawn through the one side of a triangle which is parallel to one side, or you can say if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides divided in the same ratio. So this is the proof of this. After this, I want to tell converse of this in next lecture. Converse what? Converse is this. If sides are in the same ratio, so that dividing line is parallel to the third line. If any problem here, you can send me your WhatsApp or you can tell me. I will try to explain once more. You can watch again and again this video. If any problem, tell me and solve this theorem 10 times at home. Thank you, all of you.